hello guys. Today we'll be concluding our look into the collection here. I did look up a little bit about the rating of this collection. The rating of this collection did actually really well. 9 out of 10 on Steam and 8 out of 10 by IGN, but that's all I could find on this. So today we're going to review the last five here, which is starting with Contra 3. And then the European versions of those, of some installments. But yeah, we're going to start with Contra 3. A little bit about it. It has 7.9 out of 10 on IMDb with about 200-ish user votes. It was released in 1992. On the Wikipedia reception page, CVG gave it 91%, EGM gave it 36 out of 40, Famitsu gave the game 28 out of 40, Zero gave it 92%. The SNES release of Contra 3 received considerable praise for its visual sound design. Its use of Mode 7 sprite scaling and sprite rotation was commended for being well integrated with the gameplay and not a gimmick. EGM wrote that the special effects pushed the limits of SNES hardware. Computer and Video Game CVG admired the use of Mode 7. They also both praised the soundtrack, calling a combination of orchestra and rock music. Yeah, pretty much just atmosphere and sound were really praised. Gameplay was enjoyable and a good challenge, critics found. CVG called it a cross between Strider and Midnight Resistance, and enjoyed the athletic climbing ability of the characters. In retrospect reviews, IGN called it arguably the best installment of the Contra series, and one classic deserves its place in the Video Game Hall of Fame. GameSpot also called it one of the best in the series. Both noted its satisfying level of difficulty, but said the game was somewhat short compared to modern games. Because Gamer wrote it was a good challenge and practically synonymous with Super Nintendo ownership. Eurogamer called Contra 3 exemplary and debatably one of the best games in its genre. In 97, EGN ranked the Super Nintendo version the 8th best console game of all time, marking that the game has everything. Huge bosses, mode 7 stages, ultra deep gameplay, all wrapped up in a beautifully atmospheric post-apocalyptic package. There was also some ports and re-releases as well. So overall, it did incredibly well. So let's take a look at two-player A, two-player B. I'm not quite sure what that is. It's option. What's this? Exit. Determine mount up something there. X is jump. Looks like O is the bomb. I need to see the controls. Use bomb, jump, switch weapon, fire weapon, square, spin shot, steady. Alright. Shit. Forgot, I keep square, I'm not used to the square. Shit. Thank you. 3 hits. You know, this is tough. Is that generous? Oh, spread, yeah, fucker. Shit. Shit. Oh my god. This is tough. You know, let's change something. I need more than 3. I haven't seen that kind of thing before. That kind of pacing for that division. Usually like 3-6-9 or something like that. Please have a checkpoint. Don't make me start over. Ah, it does. Brutal. Fucking brutal. Shit. Alright. Moving on. I had my fall. I like it a lot. It's really polished up. It's just... just that difficulty is tough. Alright, next we're gonna take a look at Operation C here. I'll have to bring it up here. Thank you. Operation C. This game was released in 91. IMDb has it up, but it doesn't have, like, a page in a traditional sense. Like, there's no ranking or anything like that. Reception. On Wikipedia reception page, Nintendo gave the game an 8 out of 10 score, praising gameplay, controls, enemies, weapons, music, while suggesting that the game borrowed from Super C a bit too much. It also criticized the game's lack of multiplayer option. Interesting. And the game was released in 91. So let's take a look at this thing here. Oh, wow. Yeah, it's Game Boy. Oh, jump, that's... Alright, so... Yeah, this is best with the D-pad. You have more control, kinda. I mean, stick, you can respond a bit more fluidly and quicker. Ah, of course you only got frickin' 2 lives. It is like a lot like Super Contra, Super C. That's kind of, you know, it's weird because these games are based on like the indestructible action heroes of the time, but yet they give you 3-hit deaths. I mean, if a guy in those movies got hit 3 times, it'd be like nothing to them. They'd like brush it off like it was just a slight nothing. Oh shit. Yeah, this is solid. Like, you know, graphically, with it blown up like it is, it looks fine for Game Boy. The controls are good. Yeah, the praise is correct. It's actually not a bad portable option. Oh shit, yeah, it's a game of timing. Shit. I will say, I understand the addictiveness, because the game presents itself like, yeah, it's tough, but you can do it. It's not unbeatable, you just gotta, because it makes it presentable, like, in terms of, like, a proper pattern. Fuck, I couldn't get him from behind. I just walked past it, not worth it. Oh, spread. Oh, fuck. Come on. I'll do one more. One more. Yeah, the fact that you can't do multiplayer in this is... Well, it's a Game Boy, though. It's a Game Boy port. I mean, you can only expect so much from it. Well, I kept... Keep forgetting to jump. Jumping's really key in this. Oh my god. There we go. Shit. Oh, alright. I'm gonna call it good. That's... You're only gonna get so far in that. Next is Contra Hardcore. Let's take a look at that one here. Okay, the game on IMDb, it was released in 94, it has 7.7 out of 10 on IMDb with about 100-ish user votes. On the Wikipedia reception page, game got 7.25 out of 10 by EGM, Famitsu gave the game 24 out of 40, Next Generation gave it 3 out of 5 stars, Mega gave the game 88%. GamePro gave a game a pazoo, praising the impressive bosses, eye-catching graphics, explosions, which test the limits of the TV speaker, simple control configuration, and intense action. The reviewers of EGM also gave the game a recommendation for its 4 character selection, intense action, impressive graphical effects, though they remarked that the difficulty can be extremely frustrating. Next Generation reviewed the Genesis version of the game rating a 3 out of 5, and stated that Contra Hardcore is the ultimate side-scrolling shooter and a beast of a game that won't be easily defeated, and that's official. Alright, so quite a bit here on this. So let's Konami sounds in all their games always sounded so cool to me. Just can't get enough of them. Players. Three. Music test, sound effect, control. Shit. Wrong one. The controls on here. It doesn't have controls. Some of them don't. I kind of... We'll do him. Ray. We'll do Ray. You can totally tell this is Genesis. Oh fuck yeah, look at that, yeah! Super Nintendo, you don't really have a lot of extra stuff here. Just jump and shoot. Oh man. That was barely anything. Let's try again. Oh, this is Just what a great way to kick it into high gear already. Oh, frick. Shit. Shit. Damn. Shit. This definitely a learn as you go kind of thing. Oh, hold on a sec. Sorry about that, guys. Let's resume this. I'm gonna try one more time and then I'm gonna move on to... We're gonna move on to the next thing here. Super Pro Bowl. Super Pro Bowl detector. Let me bring it up here. I assume that there's not going to be a whole lot to find with that one, considering that it's just pretty much the Europe version of Contra 3, I take it. So we're just gonna see if it talks about it in that page. Yes, in Power Rangers titles, Super, that one, and the player character is replaced with the robots. Players tasked with fighting off and all that. Yes, so pretty not much new other than the typical robots instead of whatever kind of stuff. Just do original. None of the other games have that. I wonder why they did it with that one.
actually do.
Just do 7 right off the bat. I feel like this is going to be tough. It's weird they have the 16-bit version of Provo Protector, but not the NES version. You think they would have added that too, as well. There we go, got it. That was a good run. To be honest, I'm kind of proud of that, considering that it's just a reskin Contra 3. I think I'm actually going to move on to the last one here for the collection, which is regular Provo Protector. Let's see here, let me bring it up. Finding it here, I see that they have the NES original version of it. Weirdly, they used the same name for this one. So let me, since it's 94 Genesis, I assume it's like, it's kind of a port of Genesis, like, hardcore. So let's take a look here. And the main characters and some of the enemies were renamed and replaced with robotic counterparts. Brownie was left unchanged with only his name change of the character. Plot was also rewritten as well. Gameplay seemed as North American, but the player only has 4 continues in the European version instead of 5 like North American, so it is harder. Some cutscenes were altered. It's also impossible to... Alright. And an ending was eliminated in this one. As well, so we're gonna play, check out a little bit of this too. So I guess the Provo Protectors have Hertz options. Earned a trophy here, running gun specialist. Still cool. Give it another look. I like the sliding. I didn't notice that in the American version of this game. Eh, I think we're gonna call it good. It's kind of the same thing, only just reskinned stuff. But yeah, that's all of them. I mean, of course, there's bonus book, the Japanese versions, but we'll get to that some other time in the future. But yeah, so overall, I think this is a really solid collection. I don't know if I feel like the Castlevania collection's a bit more varied, although this one, I think, technically has more games, I think. But, I don't know, it seems, they have four installments, but they have, like, a bunch of different versions of the same games. I mean, they're different enough to warrant having them on, especially Provo Protector has quite a following, despite it kind of not being that different other than the reskins. The arcade versions of the games I like having on there too, because they are different enough to qualify. I like they had included a Game Boy edition as well, but I don't know if I think it's good. It's definitely, at least as good as Castlevania, but I don't know if it's better than the Castlevania collection. Overall, I do recommend it, because the Contra games are kind of pricey, like Castlevania games, and it would cost a lot of money to get them all, and the systems and everything. This is just a great way to get them all in here, and they're ported incredibly well, in my opinion. So yeah, I do think they're a great collection to have overall, and it's not that expensive, really, to get to, so I definitely recommend it, for sure. In terms of other Contra games in the future, probably anything that's been on 6th gen, like Xbox, PS2, there was a few that I kind of want to look at, but other than that, there hasn't been a lot. Like, the newest one is garbage from what I heard, so I'm not interested in that at all. But yeah, guys, overall solid, I recommend checking out. And yeah, thanks for watching, and in case you wanted to chat with me, Mike, or anyone else at the Campy Company, and you don't want to use the YouTube comment section, we do have a couple options. First is we have a Discord channel. You can find a link to that about page /about section of our channel. We also have a discussion tab on our channel as well, and you can access that through a PC or a laptop computer. But yeah, guys, thanks for watching. Please subscribe and like the videos, and have a good day.